Here goes, Austin. Now be the time. Hold your ears. Not yet. They don't do it until like they're halfway in. I hear them sending commands.
Thank you.
There's Tesmas and a little bit of rain. Nice electronic. I'm gonna get this phone wet. Jeez. Type B. Banshee. Trailer of goods. Screamer. Seven. Certainly. Case working on the STH-10 intake.
Engineering. Oh my god, I did not get that on there right.
Have a look around at the stuff. Hopefully we'll get some rain shower here. Because it's light right now in terms of rain, but might pick it up again later. Here's a 3T. 2-2. Two, little giant, possibly 2T. Under there. No, it's a little big one. Yeah, but like mine.
Can you pretty much cut that down to like
2702. At least that's what that is. Thunderbolt. Daylight time, AM, and we are here at SirenCon. Jerry here with his mobile Directo, and I think, or no, it's Connor Vader maybe. There's the Model 7. Pretty big. I put too much zoom. 7.5 of 88 seems right. Model 2, couple of things. Model A. Ooh. Here's a 3T22. Sometimes you just need to back out a little. That's one of them. Here's the second one. It looks like a big 6SN blue. Thunderbolt. Another Thunderbolt here.
Yeah, this part ain't waterproof, so that's why it's cutting.
AOS X12 and RCM. Fire. That's the 10 panel. 612.
Who owns a Thunderbolt?
I think I saw a YouTube channel.
Yeah, these things are cool.
Is this loud enough? Can you guys all hear?
Yeah.
Alright. I'm not prepared to give a big speech. I'm never prepared to give a big speech. I'm not a speech kind of guy. But I just want to say thank you all for coming out to Rain Convention 2024. It's going to be a little wet. We will have an update from our future meteorologist. And well, it's looking a little bit better going on, so just brave the rain. I was just telling them before I have a couple guests at my house, and I was frantically mowing my yard in the rain the other day. So if I can do that, we can do this. I just want to, again, thank each and every one of you for coming out. It warms my heart to see everyone. You know, it's such a blessing to be able to provide this to you guys. It's such a niche hobby. You know, it's not something that you see every day. You know, when explaining to people, oh, I like tornado sirens, they look at you and like those things on the pole that spin, the tornado alarms. So honestly, it's so cool that we are able to do this each and every single year. And the camp too. Camp Tosomas has been so amazing to us and our organization in allowing us back every single year, providing the things that they do. I know they right now are getting ready for camp season, and they went out of their way to accommodate us to make sure that we had what we needed to provide this for you. So if you see the man in the gray van driving around, his name is Elvis, feel free to give him a thank you. He's got glasses and he that's my best description. Glasses man in the gray van. He's a decent dude.
Perfect.
Elvis.
Oh, that man right there. If you see Elvis at any point today, feel free to give him a thank you. Actually, give Elvis a round of applause right now. So I'd also like to take a second and thank each and every single one of our SirenCon staff members, volunteers, siren vendors that have been here today to make this event happen. The dedication that it takes, about a year of planning, you know, meetings, coordination, it's insane. And the dedication that's been provided by each and every single member of the staff team here in front of you is insane. So please give everyone a round of applause. Also, there are two individuals that are currently at Walmart right now shopping for the SirenCon meals today. And I'll kind of go through the itinerary with you guys. My mom for sure has her shirt on, but if you see anyone in the purple SirenCon mom shirts, feel free to say hey, give them a hug, shake their hand, whatever you guys feel comfortable with. They are here to provide meals for you guys, a mother figure for those that might not have parents here. Feel free to reach out to them and also thank them. There is a dedicated team providing meals today. To kind of go over food, there will be a lunch that is served sometime around 1 p.m. down in the SirenCon Pavilion back here. Feel free to take a break. It's going to run coincide with the siren sounding, so at your leisure, feel free to go down and have a snack. And then dinner tonight is going to be after the siren sound. We do like a group cookout. So if you want to hang around for that, everyone's invited. It's included in the donation. It's all provided to you. So feel free to stick around. I also want to encourage everyone. Every year it seems like our group thins out. I understand people got places to go, places to be. So if you got to go, that's fine. But if you have the ability to stick around until later, the grand finale is going to be pretty epic this year. And then again, just hanging out for the group cookout, we really encourage it. It's a great way for everyone to kind of, you know, officially meet each other, you know, have some conversations, you know, just enjoy the other members of this awesome hobby. Severe weather. So along with the weather, just to kind of brush on the severe weather plans, if there is lightning, we will pause the event. The Staff Hill Lounge is open to people. The SirenCon Pavilion will be open for people, or the dining hall basement will be open for people, or your vehicles. So if there's lightning, we'll temporarily pause the event. In the event of actual severe weather, so this is something like, you know, not your usual thunderstorm, you'll get a notification on your phone, or Lord, hope we don't get a tornado today. We will, the safety shelter is the dining hall basement. So at that point, the camp sirens would sound and everyone would be asked to seek shelter. But today I think it's just a little bit of rain. So, and we will push through it. We are a rain or shine event, so we are for the first time really testing our rain capabilities. With that, again, thank you all for coming. We're gonna kinda go through each sector's, we've got the weather update, and then we're gonna go through some rules and safety things too. And then if anyone else has anything to add, and then we'll do a group picture. So again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you all for coming. I should ask, are you guys excited? I don't think you guys are excited. Are you sure you're excited? I don't know. How about one more? One more question. Are you guys sure? Are you absolutely positive you're pumped for some sirens today?
Yeah!
That's more like it. All right, here is Holly with our weather update.
Okay, so I guess I'm kind of put on the spot. So according to the National Weather Service, we're just expecting rain after one. There is possibility of thunderstorms, but thankfully nothing severe, so I don't think we will be needing to seek shelter, but obviously I'm going to keep an eye on everything. If I see anything that's concerning, I'm going to let someone know, and then we'll go from there.
All right, thanks, Holly. All right, guys, so I'm Zach. I'm on the security team here. We're just going to go over a couple ground rules for the event. We want everyone to have a safe and fun time. So first thing is alcohol for our adults is not permitted anywhere in the park or camp areas. If it's seen, it will be taken. You know, it's a hard rule that because we're on a scout camp, we can't be having any alcohol. So obviously tonight afterwards, feel free to enjoy some beverages, but just not on our campsite. The next thing we're going to talk about is our driving policy. For those of you who drove here today, we adhere to a 15-mile-an-hour speed limit anywhere. Don't be exceeding that. Be cautious of other people. We have a lot of people coming around. So if you're driving, please drive safe, drive smart, and make sure that we're not endangering anybody. The next thing on my list is our perimeter rules. So as you guys can see, we have a caution tape line up here. This year, again, safety is very important. We got a lot of heavy equipment. So crossing this line is not permitted unless you are a siren owner and your siren is about to be sounded. You cannot otherwise cross the line at all. If you do, you're going to be given one warning only. So please be cautious of that. Don't be going over the line for any reason. If you feel like you need to cross the line for any reason, contact a member of staff and we'll discuss it with you first. Everybody, that sound good so far?
Yeah!
Awesome. Oh, let's see, I got a whole list here. Our next rule is on hearing protection. Raise your hand if you do not currently have earplugs or earmuffs with you. Raise your hand. Super high. That's what I love to see. I don't see any hands up right now. As you guys may have seen, hearing protection is required at our event. It's not going to be strictly enforced right now, but again, it's a rule here that hearing protection needs to be worn. We don't want you guys to damage your hearing, especially when these sirens are ground level and just a few feet away from you. They're rated for a lot louder from a lot further away. So be smart, be safe, wear that hearing protection when those sirens are going off, and we'll be good. For those of you staying on the camp tonight, our quiet hours start at 11 p.m. tonight. So following 11 p.m., please make sure you're being courteous of other people, staying quiet. Again, no alcohol in those campsites as well. But if you have any questions about any of those rules, you can contact any member of staff. And then the last thing I said, last thing I have is be respectful of each other, of the staff, of your space. We want to make sure that everyone here is having a good time. So making sure that, you know, we're being respectful of other people, being kind and courteous. With cameras, please make sure you're being mindful of how your camera setup is affecting other people's views. If you are in the very front, do not have your tripod at the highest setting. Let's try to lower that down so that people behind you have a chance to see things. So keeping your tripods and your cameras, obviously we want you guys to film and have fun and post these videos and share the event, but just make sure we're being mindful of how our cameras are affecting other people's views. Like Josh said, that's all I got. Everybody ready?
Yeah!
Awesome. I'm gonna turn it over to Sean here with our electrical team.
I don't have anything specific electrical to talk about. However, I did want to actually get some demographic information where people are actually from. So, raise your hand if you are from the Eastern time zone. Okay, how about Central? Oh, yeah, that's me, yeah. Okay, Now let's... Oh yeah, how about mountain time?
There he is.
Oh, there they are. And how about Pacific? Now who drove the furthest, or who's traveled the furthest this year? Okay, how about this? Who here is not even from the United States or this continent? Raise your hand. There he is. So, yeah, as you can see, this event has gone to a point where people are traveling and going out of their way, traveling thousands and thousands and thousands of miles. And we really appreciate every single last one of you, you know, coming here and, you know, validating what we're doing. And, I mean, I'm not one accustomed to public speaking, so that's all I really have to say.
Alright, and then just to tie everything up, at this point, registration will open back up, so if you have not registered, if you've registered online, there's still some steps to complete at the SirenCon Pavilion. If you haven't registered, feel free to register down at the Pavilion. There's myself and a couple others on guest services will be down there. We'll take care of you, get you a wristband. Everyone is required to have a wristband. It just kind of makes sure that we, you know, you signed everything needed to make sure that everyone's safe. So, and then, train of thought. Mini sirens will start at 11. It's kind of not necessarily free-for-all, but just a dedicated hour where if you have a mini siren, we will have the power necessary to plug her in and let them go. At noon, we will be doing larger sirens. So right at noon, we'll start right away with the larger, you know, anything that's larger than a Model 2, basically. And then we will finish with the grand finale later. I brushed on meal times. And at any point, that's what I was thinking, at any point you guys need anything from anyone, find us. We're in the orange staff shirts, or my mom is in the purple SirenCon mom shirt. Feel free to find one of us if you have questions, places to go. We'll be able to take care of you guys. That's what we're here for. Just a quick announcement. I know some of you know, just with everything this year, we kind of changed how we did things. The camp sirens will not be sounded, unfortunately. However, again, in the event of severe weather, that is what they are there for. So they would go off for that. I just want to make that disclaimer. Yeah, so that's pretty much all I have. Again, if you guys have any questions, any concerns, feel free to find one of us in the staff shirts. We'll take care of you. Again, I'll be down in the SirenCon Pavilion for a bit. Oh, one last thing. Our vendor, our sponsor of SirenCon this year specifically, they donated the activation equipment required to make this event run. We kind of changed that. SWS guys, if you see them in the, they'll be wearing the neon yellow shirts, feel free to give them a thank you. But I am looking for a parent volunteer. If there's a parent volunteer that's not, you know, doing a whole lot, you're looking for something to do, come find me at the pavilion. We at some point are going to be setting up kind of like the activation central area with, there's a tent that we gotta put up. So I'm gonna be out in the rain putting that up, and if there's anyone that wants to assist with that, the more hands the better. So feel free to find me down at the SirenCon Pavilion. Probably sometime when the mini sirens are sounding, we'll go ahead and get that set up for those guys. Again, feel free to thank them for donating the equipment necessary to run the event. That's all I have. Have a good time, and thank you again for coming.
Yeah.
See how big the camera has?
Registration is now open again. The other announcement I have for you is at exactly noon, this siren right here, the Siren Tone EOWS612 will be activating. Exactly noon, first big siren. Stand by.
Mm-hmm. was originally installed in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. It's from 1952. We're just getting it warmed up right now. This is your 60-second warning. We're going to be firing the mobile directo up. beautiful machine. That is awesome. Thank you, Jerry, for bringing that out here. Next up, we've got a Model 7 over here. It is this. This is your 60-second warning on the Model 7. We all know and love this siren. They're everywhere. Just a quick show of hands. Who has one of these within 10 miles of their house? Okay, that's a fair amount. So we'll get her going here in just a second for you guys.
Mm-hmm.
change out.
This is your 60-second warning. 60 seconds.
Here we go.
I know.
This is your 30-second warning for the reverse wired Thunderbolt.
10-second warning, guys. Here we go.
Thank you. Everybody give it up for the 2001. give it up for the Federal Code Mach 3.
We were given the 60-second warning.
Sorry about the delay there.
Thank you.
Alright, everybody, give it up for Alex's screamer.
Behind me.
What?
Right here. Holy crap.
As you can see, we've got some big stuff in store for you.
No! Oh my god. They were not buying one of these damn figures.
What is that? The second round of Siren in the room.
This is the 30-second warning for the ex-Cincinnati SD-10. This is Michael Siren. Alright folks, sorry about that short test, the motor hit. Thank you.
It vibrated.
I unplugged my, like, I put my fingers up for a second when the horn was aiming right at me. Never again.
No.
Imagine you did that with a P50. Gone.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, that gave me a good ring.
All right, everybody. Next up is the RM130. It's back here by the generator. Got about a 30-second warning on that.
No.
Not yet.
Now it is.
Oh, they're all running. Oh, here we go.
Question.
off.
Okay, so the rotator rotor is not going to work anymore. For attack, it's going to be just chopper.
We're going to do another one.
So it's not going to be too bad now because it's pointed away.
Yeah.
So it's essentially a cyclone now. In one direction. Oh man, I smell that smoke. Focus on Jen.
Thing fried.
Hold it up, hold it up.
Oh shit.
Yeah, it fried. Yeah, it zoomed out.
Yeah.
SirenCon's over, everyone's packing up and going away, and the mosquitoes are coming out to eat me alive, all the fun stuff, and that's done. Better be a nice lawn ornament.
That's what I